think that there are a number of commonalities, so they're kind of structural, social, and political struggles that we are waging, which will benefit from us getting together and learning better from each other. So, it's part of the fact that we produce different things in Africa and export. It's part of the different immediate products that we have. We are all, in a certain sense, primary commodity exporting regions where we export only unprocessed products, even tourism. Right. And we just import everything that we need in manufacturing terms. That itself, you know, creates a situation of imbalance and unequal exchange in the rest of the world. Now, it's something that we cannot resolve as individual countries. We have to resolve a collective of countries. But in resolving them, we are facing a global order, which has determined that we are inserted in a particular way. So our ability to get together from Africa to the Caribbean, Latin America, and go, increase our chances to struggle better in the global order to redress or to reverse that kind of in-between. So that's an important element.
There's a tremendous amount that we can learn from each other in relation to how we construct regionalism.
Right.
Certainly we need to go beyond the open-led regionalism models that are both attempted, both at the level of the Caribbean in relation to the Caribbean single market and economy, that doesn't really have a nurtured industrial deepening project girding it, and certainly the ambitious regional integration plans in Africa. We need to know that these plans move beyond the EU project. I think we need to be prepared to produce knowledge and share with the rest of the world, you know, exemplar features, or exemplary features of what we're trying to do as we build regionalism. We need to integrate more along that front. Yeah. There's talk about South-South trade, but it's hardly anything about South-South trade and development and shared visions of what an ideal sustainable development future or futures can look like. And I think we need to just share more, produce that knowledge and those examples for the rest of the world to emulate.
So we can exchange ideas. But I think more importantly is what comes in terms of building each other's confidence. You know, when I come from Ghana and I meet somebody from the Caribbean, I can say that talking about the same things I'm talking about, going through the same experience, I can say, so this is not my problem. It's not because I'm too short or I'm too stupid and I'm facing those problems. It's a similar problem of humanity. And we actually can work together, so it gives you hope. So you can think that beyond your particular situation, there are some things that you can benefit. I think strongly that is the most important element. The leverage for hope and optimism.
And for me, what was powerful about today's exchange as well is that the different presentations, different thematically, but the way in which there were synergies across what is at the root and also the policy proposals around structural transformative change.
Exactly. And those policies as substantive questions we can actually learn from each other,
yes.
Formulate them better, benefit from each other's policies and experiences, and adopt the one.
And for critique.
Absolutely.